Time for Mr. Truck, reviewing the latest innovations for your truck and trailer.
The Bronco is coming! The Bronco is coming! One more week to get all the details, but it's going to have a two-door model, four-door model, and a sport model. And here's some history about the Bronco, 1966.
Hi, I'm Ted Ryan. I'm an Archives and Heritage Brand Manager for the Ford Motor Company, and you're actually in our archives. We set up a Bronco display with some never-before-seen items, and I want to give you a brief tour and an overview of the Bronco. The Bronco started during World War II when Ford built more than 270,000 Jeeps for the U.S. Army. We took that know-how on 4x4 equipment and turned it into the Bronco beginning in 1963. Before me are some documents that you've never seen before. Ford's official communications were always done on blue sheets of paper. So this one in 1963 established a program codenamed Bronco. And that program from October was approved in February with this memo signed by Lee Iacocca. This is the origins of the Bronco project. Here's some of the alternate names and different variations on what the Bronco could have been called. One of my favorite objects in the entire archives was when I found this 1963 memo that identified the Bronco program as the GOAT, goes over any terrain. That was a groundbreaking moment for me, and I immediately shared that with the design team to make sure that we were on the Bronco DNA. If you follow me over here, now we get to celebrate some of the trims and some of the features and some of the colors of Bronco. I love some of these names, Tidewater Aqua, Ragoon Red. Those are the type of colors that made the Bronco stand out, and when you saw a Bronco in the wild, you knew what you were seeing. This particular one right here is actually called Diamond Blue. Once again, a distinctive name and a distinctive color for the Bronco. So if you follow me over here, we're going to celebrate some of the Bronco racing heritage. So behind me here, you see some of the Baja materials, some of the racing materials. Bill Stropp was given a pre-production version of the Bronco that he modified, and he actually began to win races. In fact, in 1969, the Bronco became the only four-wheel drive vehicle to win the entire Baja race, a record that still stands today. Over here you see Bronco at work and play. That's the beauty of the Bronco, was it was used by police department, it was used by forest rangers, it was used by people that ran ranches. If you were an off-roader, you could take your Bronco anywhere and do anything with it, which was what the beauty of the Bronco was. It was a life vehicle, a work vehicle, and a play vehicle. And you can see it was customized pretty quickly for police departments to be able to use in rural areas. If you follow me over here, the Bronco became a pop culture icon. It went away in 1996 when the American public was demanding four-door vehicles and the SUV market was born. There wasn't really a place for a two-door Bronco, but it was immersed in pop culture. And there's a couple distinctive moments. Here you see a series of documents when we converted the Bronco into a Popemobile in 1979. We modified three Broncos and gave them to the Secret Service, and you can see Pope John Paul II and his Bronco in Yankee Stadium. And who can forget the slow chase with O.J. Simpson? 95 million Americans watch O.J. Simpson cruising down the freeways of Los Angeles, where the Bronco became even more meshed in pop culture. On top of that, the Bronco has appeared in more than 1,200 movies over time, some classic titles. My personal favorite is Ocean 11, but it's been in thousands of movies. And then there's actually a distinct group of Bronco collectors in Iceland. Believe it or not, more Broncos were sold into Iceland than any other country per capita. And it was almost from the very beginning that these Broncos were in the wild. It makes sense. You need the off-road ability, and you want the comfort and driving. And there's actually a Broncos of Iceland Instagram page and some of the early ads from Broncos in Iceland. The Bronco's been gone for 25 years, and I'm so excited that we're bringing it back. It shares so much of the DNA with the first generation of the Bronco, and we're just about to release it into the wild.
Bronco coined the term sport utility vehicle back in 1966. There's only one Bronco that's authentic to the Bronco DNA, that has the open air experience of the Bronco, the off-road capability, and the ready for fun adventure. And customers are excited to bring back the new Bronco. This new Bronco is the sixth generation of Bronco, and it has a unique opportunity to provide a modern SUV for the market. We've taken a lot of time to understand the DNA of Bronco, what makes a Bronco, and at the same time integrate new technology, new solutions for the customer to make this the best and most modern SUV available. Built Wild describes the DNA of the Bronco. It describes the unparalleled durability of the vehicle. We've tested it out in the wild in some extreme environments such as Johnson Valley. It describes the design DNA that's purposeful and true to the design of all Broncos. And it also describes the capability of the Bronco that it can go over any type of terrain. Bronco Nation is an online community set up by Bronco enthusiasts. It's independent from Ford, and it's a singular place for Bronco fans and enthusiasts to go and learn more about Bronco and the Bronco lifestyle. Bronco Off Rodeo is included with the purchase of your Bronco 2 or 4-door or your Bronco Sport Badlands series. It's an opportunity for new owners to experience and learn about the capability of their vehicle from off-road instructors and also learn about the Bronco lifestyle in one of four outstanding epic locations across the U.S. Bronco is now a family of vehicles. The Bronco 2-door is really the soul of the Bronco family. It's the image and capability leader of the Bronco family. It also connects us to the heritage of Bronco, as all Broncos in the past have been 2-doors. For the first time ever, we'll have a Bronco 4-door. That's for those customers that need to carry more people or more cargo, and that'll be a great option for them. And then we have the Bronco of small SUVs, the Bronco Sport. That's the price entry vehicle into the Bronco family. So at the time of launch, we'll have over 200 accessories from the factory available on the new Bronco and over 100 accessories on the Bronco Sport.
I think this is the right time for Bronco because I think if you look at the market right now, off-road vehicles are hot. Everybody wants them. Everybody wants to be a part of it. And I think that we're going to bring something fresh and new. So this is our opportunity to really set a whole new trajectory for off-road vehicles. And so there's no better time than now. I think everybody wants it. I think they've been waiting for it. The Bronco is absolutely unique. It's going to set a whole new chinning bar for what off-roading really means. We're going to be able to leverage our heritage. We've got all fresh new products, all new four-door. I mean, we're really going to set a whole new trajectory for off-road performance. So heritage can be a constraint or it can be an asset. And it all depends on how you approach it. So if you want to live in the past, then that's probably going to be a mistake. But if you take that rich history that you have and you leverage it and you go forward with it, then you can have something special. And that's what the Bronco is doing. We've got that rich heritage. We know what a Bronco is. We know what it needs to be. But now we've interpreted it in a brand new product. And we're going to show people what Bronco is all about.
If you have a short bed truck, you know it's not easy to hook up to a gooseneck. Pop-Up came out with these extensions from 9 inches to 16 inches to keep you from breaking out your back window when you're pulling a gooseneck trailer. And everybody uses a short bed. That's the most proper truck there is, a crew cab short bed. So check that window.